A very good morning to all my dear students of class 11 of the science stream, commerce stream and the humanities stream. Once again, I welcome you in my English e-learning class. Students, in my previous class, I have already told you about the poet, that is Walt Whitman, of the poem The Voice of the Wren. I have told you the central idea of the poem. I have also given you the summary of the poem. I told you the significance of the title of the poem, that is The Voice of the Wren. And I have also told you the message conveyed through this poem by the poet Walt Whitman. Now students, in today's class, I will be explaining to you the poem. So I thought of dividing this poem into four stanzas. This poem is written in free verse, okay, and I myself thought of dividing it into four stanzas. Today's class we will be doing the first stanza and the second stanza, okay. The first stanza starts from, "And who art thou? Said I to the soft falling shower, which, strange to tell, gave me an answer," as here translated. "I am the poem of earth," said the voice of the rain. This is the first stanza. And the second stanza, "Eternal I rise, impalpable out of the land and the bottomless sea, upward to heaven, whence vaguely formed, altogether changed, and yet the same." So till here we will be doing, and I will be explaining to you line by line, as well as I will be giving the meanings also to y'all, okay, from these two stanzas. And in my next class, I will be continuing the next part of the poem, which will be left out, okay. My dear students, don't forget to put your attendance in the comment box. This is the reminder which I am giving you again and again in each of my video classes, because we the teachers are keeping a record of your attendance daily. And if you like my explanation, if you understand my explanation, kindly subscribe my channel. Now you follow my explanation, which I will be explaining to you line by line. My dear students, you look into page number 41 of the book Hornbill, The Voice of the Wren by Walt Whitman. "And who art thou? Said I to the soft falling shower, which, strange to tell, gave me an answer," as here translated. What do the first two lines of the poem mean? The poem begins with the poet, that is Walt Whitman, asking for the identity of the soft falling rain shower. Much to the surprise of the poet, the rain replies to his question, which the poet translates for his readers. Now students, you just look into the word thou. What is the meaning of the word thou? It means you. Soft falling. What is the meaning of the word soft falling? Dropping softly. What is the meaning of the word shower? Raindrops, when they fall continuously on earth. Now students, you look into the third line of the poem. "I am the poem of earth," said the voice of the rain. What does this line mean? Here, much to the surprise of the poet, the rain replies to the poet's question, that is, it is the rain who is the poem of the earth, which the poet translates it for his readers. Now, students, you look into the next lines. Eternal I rise, impalpable out of the land and the bottomless sea, upward to heaven, winds vaguely formed, altogether changed and yet the same. What do these lines mean? The rain said that it was the poem of the earth and it rose continuously from the land and bottomless ocean in the form of vapors. The rain tells the poet that it rises upwards towards the sky in the form of vapor, where it changes its form, that is, condenses into water droplets. It also says that although its form gets changed, it still remains the same. Now, students, if you look into the stanza 2, what do the following words mean? Now, students, what is meant by the word eternal? Eternal means everlasting. What does the word impalpable mean? Impalpable means unable to be felt by touching. What is meant by bottomless? Bottomless means very deep. Whence? What is meant by the word whence? It is from where. Vaguely. What is vaguely? Unclearly. And formed. The word formed means made into a specific shape or form. Students, in my first class or in my previous class, I have told you that the poem The Voice of the Rain by Walt Whitman is basically a conversation between the poet and the rain. The rain explains its eternal journey in its birthplace, that is, earth, to the poet. In this poem, The Voice of the Rain, we find there are two voices. What are those voices? One is the voice of the rain and the other is the voice of the poet Walt Whitman. The lines which indicate the voice of the rain are, I am the poem of earth, said the voice of the rain. And the lines which indicate the voice of the poet are, and who art thou, said I to the soft falling shower. So, my dear students, today I am concluding my class. Up till here, you go through the poem, the first two stanzas till today where I have explained to you. And in my next class, I will be continuing my explanation and I will give you the meanings as I have done it today. Thank you, students. Bye-bye.